Good evening, everyone. This is Cruz de la Cruz here with Stephen Fiennes from the O2 Arena here in London, England, to bring you ESW Anarchy. I am so excited, aren't you, Stephen?
Oh, absolutely. I am wired up here in jolly old England for ESW Anarchy from the O2 Arena. We're kicking things off here red hot with mixed tag team action. Here we have the Moretti crime family. We have Sophia Moretti, the head of the Moretti crime family, and Sal Moretti, the hitman, the mafioso of the Moretti crime family. And they are looking for blood, Cruz.
Oh, right you are, Steven. Their journey here to Anarchy has started, you know, weeks ago, months ago. Back in episode, I believe, 3 of ESW Saturday Night Fight Night, when Madison Shaw of the Unit Club attacked Sophia after their qualifying match in the Diamonds Division title tournament. And ever since then, these two have been at each other. These factions have been warring with each other. And out here, we have Madison Shaw, the ESW Diamonds Division champion, with the president of the Unit Club, Unit. This should be quite a contest, wouldn't you agree, Steven?
Oh, right you are, Cruz. I mean, here comes the Black Mamba herself, Madison Shaw, the ESW Diamonds Division champion, and she's been running roughshod over the entire Diamonds Division. And yeah, she's the one that kickstarted this war between the Unit Club and the Moretti crime family. And she may have started this war, and she's going to look to finish it here tonight. And Unit, well, he's just going to back her up like always.
And I'm pretty sure Unit wants some type of retribution from that loss he had against Sal a few weeks ago on Rise.
Oh, right you are. I mean, yeah, Sal pretty much stole that victory with a roll-up pin. And yeah, Unit's going to be out for blood as well.
This should be quite a contest. It may be the culmination of this feud. We just don't know. So let's get this ready, kick the action off here from London, England. ESW Anarchy, Unit Club versus the Moretti crime family. Here we go. All right, the lady's starting us off. Sophia coming out hot with a drop kick. Picking her up. Whipped into the corner. Oh, big hip check.
You always got to love a little girl-on-girl action, huh, Cruz?
Oh, you ain't lying. Here we go. Big right hand from Sophia. Sophia and Sal sporting a new look here tonight with the pink and black.
Oh yeah, loving it here. Looking red hot here. And oh, Madison to the outside. And now Sophia just showing off to this England crowd.
And over the last few months and weeks, it seems like the ESW faithful seemed to turn the other way with the Moretti crime family. They seem to be enduring them in this journey.
Yeah, I mean, it was... The Moretti crime family, they're really endearing themselves to the crowd here, you know, with their struggles with the Unit Club. Because the Unit Club has really had their number this whole entire time that they've been at war.
Oh, you're right, Steven. I can only think of maybe a couple times that the Moretti's actually got the upper hand on them. And they've had quite a few run-ins with each other.
Well, absolutely. You could probably look at tonight's match as the war to settle the score, so to speak.
Well, we'll just have to wait and see. I mean, if you're a betting man, who would you bet on here? I mean, I'm betting on Unit Club. They've been dominant this entire time.
I gotta say, I'm right there with you, Cruz. I mean, the numbers don't lie. You know, as a good mathematician, Scott Steiner, once said, you know, the numbers don't lie, and Unit Club, you know, have many victories over the Moretti crime family, so you have to give them the advantage here.
Oh,
so but it looks like Sophia's making a little bit of a comeback here.
Right you are, Steven. Sophia actually showing, you know, quite a bit of aggression here, what she needs to have against Madison Shaw. And that's something that maybe that has been lacking, you know, from the Morettis, is, you know, that cutthroat ideology of, you know, because the Unit Club, you know, they take no prisoners. Oh, big flatliner.
The most popular move in ESW. Yeah.
Oh, missed the spear.
You're absolutely right, but, like, don't...
Oh.
You can't count the Moretti crime family out. I mean, as you can see, Sophia coming back here with a vengeance, with some clubbing blows to the spine here. Like, the Moretti crime family are dangerous individuals.
Oh, they are.
I mean, they all wear black gloves for a reason.
Right you are, Stephen.
They've seen and done many things. So, I, you know, the unit club are dangerous, but you can't, you know, discount the awful things that the Moretti crime family are capable of doing.
Oh, you're right, Stephen. Madison needed to get out of there. Got a breather. Unit and Sal squaring off here. Oh.
Yeah, went for a big stomp, but Sal just said, nah.
Into the corner.
No, Sal is just unloading on the unit.
Oh, just choking him in the corner. You better be careful not to get disqualified here.
It's not the first time that he's done that.
Oh, I know you're right. Oh, you didn't miss the clothesline. So did Sal.
They're both so evenly matched here. Oh, with a sling blade by Unit.
Oh, and a basement drop kick.
To the dome. And now just working on that arm and elbow. And tag back into the Black Mamba. And here comes Sophia as well.
Oh,
a snake bite out of nowhere.
That could be it.
Oh, but Sophia kicks out of the snake bite and Madison Shaw can't believe it.
Oh, the look on her face says it all.
Shock and awe.
Sophia just plowed her way through it. Oh, went for a spear. Sophia countered into a DDT.
Great counter by the head of the Moretti crime family.
Madison Shaw is definitely off her game after Sophia kicked out of that snake bite.
Oh, and a step-up Superman punch looked like.
Indeed. Madison tagging out, trying to gather her wits about her.
Here come the men.
Oh, big clothesline by Sal.
And the Mafioso is on a roll here. Oh, went for a basement dropkick, got nothing.
Same thing for Unit.
So evenly matched, crew. And another sling blade. And another basement dropkick by Unit.
Unit was thinking about going to the top, but second thought it. Whipped into the ropes. Another sling blade. Oh, a basement dropkick to the knee.
He's chopping him down.
Tagged in Madison.
Here come the ladies again. And a spear by the Black Mamba.
Got the spear that time.
Now just stomping away at Sophia for good measure.
Sophia blocks.
She's fighting back with strikes. Backing her up into the corner. We've seen this before. A flurry of back elbow strikes.
To the dome. Oh!
And a Bronco Buster, and I'm so jealous of Madison Shaw right now.
Aren't we all?
Picks her up.
Swinging. It was a swinging slam.
Pretty sure she calls that the Jersey Turnpike. And the winners, Moretti crime family. And oh my God, let's take another look here.
Those big forearm attacks by Sophia.
And that snake bite out of nowhere, but Sophia just would not stay down. And they hit that Jersey Turnpike slam.
I'm in shock, Stephen.
I'm bewildered. The Moretti crime family have pulled off a huge victory here in the opening match of ESW Anarchy.
And needless to say, I doubt the Unit Club are going to let this settle. All right, ladies and gentlemen, up next, the ESW Claim to Fame Battle Royal, where 10 superstars are vying for a contract and vying to be crowned the new ESW YouTube champion. I am so excited, aren't you, Steven?
Oh, I am so excited to see this Battle Royal, this Claim to Fame Battle Royal. 10 superstars who have never stepped foot in ESW are trying to win a contract here, but also trying to win the ESW YouTube Championship, brand new championship here in ESW. And first out, we have Gav, the gift of Gav.
He is quite the visual appeal here, Steven. We don't know much about Gav other than he has, you know, he's made his rounds in other federations and whatnot. But he has garnered quite a bit of head of steam, you know, qualifying here, making his way here for this Battle Royal. And we have got a who's who of people in this Battle Royal here this evening. And up next? Who do we have next? And the entrants are chosen at random here for the Battle Royal. So these guys don't know who's coming next. All right. There's Gav. All right. Let's see who is next.
Introducing the individual.
It is Jay Evans. I have heard a lot about this guy, Steven. He is quite a competitor. You know, it seems like he's made his rounds, you know, all around the world, and now he wants to prove himself here in ESW, you know, to earn a contract. And I would think to be, you know, even more exciting is to be the inaugural ESW YouTube champion. I know all these guys, once it was announced that the title was up for grabs as well, they all got a new level of intensity.
Oh, absolutely. I mean, yeah, that's the thing that's driving all 10 of these wannabe superstars, ESW superstars, is that chance to become the first ever in ESW history, ESW YouTube champion. And yeah, here comes Jay Evans. And like you said, he's been all over the world, you know, harnessing his craft, perfecting his craft. And these are the first two superstars here to start off this battle royal.
And here we go. Oh, fast and furious already with a Samoan drop by Evans. Gav countering back here. Oh, eat the feet out the gate. They're just coming out guns a-blazing here.
All right, you are. I mean, with what's at stake, you have to. Some fast-paced action here. And here comes the next competitor.
Here in 6 seconds. 5, 4... 3, 2, and 1.
And here comes Harper Pierce.
Harper Pierce. I don't know much about this competitor other than him and King Anthony Martin seem to know each other. Anthony Martin was the one that more or less... Whoa!
Oh, what a springboard reverse Rana by Harper Pierce.
I was saying Anthony Martin was the one who more or less referred the ESW management to include Harper Pierce here. And we got another competitor about to come in.
Oh, look at this, just pulling at him.
My goodness. The action's fast and furious here. Jason Swick. Now, I do know a thing or two about Jason Swick. He was a competitor for Ring of Fire Wrestling for a very long time, one of their top guys. And back in the day, Juan Soto would actually go to Ring of Fire Wrestling, and Jason Swick was one of his biggest rivals here, so Jason Swick has a little familiarity with at least one of the competitors here in ESW. And Jason Swick, a former world champion for Ring of Fire Wrestling and for Slam City Wrestling, and you know, he should be quite a combatant here. Oh, and Nick Nitro coming out next. Nick Nitro coming from the ZWZ promotion, and I don't know a lot about Nick, but he's been a staple of that promotion for quite some time.
Just ate a boot to the face there.
Jay Evans is trying to get up off the canvas here.
This is just so far just some chaotic action just everywhere.
Oh, right you are. Another competitor about to enter. No eliminations yet. Oh, to the arm.
Here comes King Dell.
King Dell, I believe King Dell is all, you know, is from, we're in his native country, I believe. Oh.
And King Dell gets hit with a Northern Lights suplex.
Nick Nitro with the offense here. Is it just me, or it looks like Jason Swick and Nick Nitro went to the same tattoo artist?
I think so.
They have good taste, though, in tattoos.
Yeah, great taste.
They got some Star Wars tats. I like it. I'm a big Star Wars guy, aren't you, Steve?
Oh, yeah, you gotta love Star Wars. Right, I think Spock is my favorite character.
Wrong franchise, Steven. That's Star Trek.
Oh, okay. Excuse me, I'm a Slytherin.
All right, out next, Travis Oliver, the final boss of Slam City Wrestling. Travis Oliver, another competitor who is somewhat familiar with ESW's competitors. Like I said, back in the day, they did some brand trading, you know, some interpromotional wars here, and Travis Oliver and Juan Soto again have a long storied history of competitions. Oliver already down.
Suzuki Zhao here at number 8.
Now, I don't know a lot about him. Let's see here. From Japan. And he would definitely... Oh, just ate a super kick.
What a kick to the dome.
And he would definitely fit right in with some of our Eastern competitors here in ESW.
All right, you are.
But then again, Tokyo Thunder doesn't look as nearly as a traditionally Japanese as Kazao here. All right, here we go, tie up. We've got 8 competitors in already. 2 more left.
With no eliminations thus far.
Wrenching on that head, Jay Evans. My goodness, Nitro getting out of it.
Just trying to wear him down because obviously you're not gonna win the match that way. But and, oh, what a powerbomb! Crucifix powerbomb. Sit out.
Oh man. My goodness. Actually, Fast and Furious here. What do we have here from Nitro?
So chaotic.
Big brainbuster. It's hard to keep track of all the action, Steven.
Right, you are. Yeah, it's just an action going everywhere, all at once.
Oh, Gav was going for a springboard. Stopped by Harper. Oh, big German by Gav. Oh, Nippo. Oh, man.
What a kick by Zhao.
Oh, another kick. Those feet are lethal.
Yeah, those agitated feet there.
Oh, what good DDT. These guys are throwing everything out there.
Well, with a chance to be the first ever ESW YouTube champion, I don't blame them.
Oh, right you are, Steven.
You have to throw everything that you have.
Oh, another kick. My goodness, Travis Oliver just eating up there. Oh, Oliver against the ropes. Oh, and Travis Oliver, the first one to be eliminated here. My goodness.
Thanks for coming, Oliver.
Oh!
And like Zhao was almost eliminated there.
Oh, counter. Back in. Nick Nitro out.
Now the eliminations are starting to come.
My goodness.
There goes Zhao into the corner.
Oh, Jay Evans with a one-winged angel. My goodness.
Just putting him down.
My goodness. This has been nonstop action. Next competitor. Got to make your way out.
Forearm to the back of the head. Here comes Renegade Ross Snodgrass.
Out to the ring. And I know a little something about Snodgrass here. He's been a world travel competitor for as long as ESW has been around. You know, so he's familiar with some of the competitors here as well. Yeah, but he's been a world champion all over the world, and he's, you know, finally wanting to officially be part of ESW. Oh, man. Snodgrass with a lot of offense here, the Renegade. Oh, we had another elimination. Oh, looks like it was Jay Evans is out. And next, the last competitor here, main event, Jackson Ave. My goodness. And Jackson Ave, a former competitor for RTW, long withstanding history in our industry. Yeah, a lot of folks would say he's the favorite here tonight.
A lot of people would say he's the favorite. And, I mean, it's hard to bet against somebody like that. Somebody who calls themselves main event, they have a lot to prove.
Oh, right, you are, Steven. Gav trying to eliminate Dell here in the corner. What's going to happen?
Looks like he's still struggling.
All the competitors are in now. So one of these men will be the inaugural ESW YouTube champion.
And Zhao on the verge of being eliminated here by Ross Snodgrass. But Zhao fights out.
Oh, someone just got dumped out. Looks like it was Gav. Gav is out.
He gave the gift of Gav a gift of elimination.
Right you are, Steve. It looks like we got six competitors left here. Oh, Zal just wearing Snodgrass out in the corner.
That unique offense from Zal.
Oh.
A Northern Lights suplex by Ross Snodgrass. And here we are here. Still all this chaotic action. One of these men will walk out as the ESW YouTube champion. And here we go. King Dell on the verge of being eliminated here. And he's out. King Dell is out. And here we are. Go behind here. Looks like he's on the verge of being eliminated here. He's trying to push him out, and there he goes. We are down to our final four competitors here. We have Jason Swick, Jackson Av, Ross Snodgrass, and Kazuki Zal. One of these four men will be crowned the ESW YouTube champion. And oh, what a Canadian destroyer onto Ross Snodgrass. Now Jackson Av just pounding away at Kazuki Zal.
Action fast and furious here, Steven. My goodness, the final four here. Oh, big DDT by Snodgrass. Oh, Snodgrass missed the springboard here. Oh, what do we have in mind here? Oh, just hung out to dry. My goodness. Ooh, big float over neckbreaker by Main Event. What do we have here? Oh my goodness.
Oh my God, angel's wings.
Oh, big last shot by Jason Swick. Oh, big flapjack. You won't find that at Waffle House.
Oh, no, you won't.
What's Jason Swick have in mind here? Oh,
what
man.
A unique suplex. And now Swick on the ropes here, on the verge of being eliminated by Kazuki Zal.
Oh, on the apron. Can he get him here?
Can he push him out here?
And oh, he does.
We're down to the final three here, Cruz.
Man, this has been quite a contest, Steven. Oh!
All of these men want to be crowned the ESW YouTube champion.
Zal with that unique offense there. Some type of octopus hold, looks like. Oh, Main Event countered it.
Into that sidewalk slam, and now Renegade Ross Snodgrass has Main Event Jackson Av.
Oh, is he going to get him here?
On the verge of elimination.
If Snodgrass eliminates Main Event, that's quite a feather in his cap.
Oh, absolutely. But he just couldn't push him out, and now Zal with a springboard back elbow.
Didn't get all of it, but that's enough. Oh, big forearm to the back of the dome. Oh.
Kazuki Zal with a big clothesline into the corner.
Pulling him out feet first. Just like is that a breech berth feet first?
It looks like, yeah. Oh, what a sit-out slam.
Back elbow by Snodgrass. Oh, man.
What a suplex.
I think that was a Regalplex.
Looked like it.
Oh, big backbreaker by Snodgrass here. sidestep. Oh, big clothesline took him down.
Now Zhao being led to the ropes. About to be eliminated, looks like.
Nope, fighting out of it. Oh, big kicks in the face.
Those educated feet of Zhao.
Oh,
suplex just fun.
Folded him up. Zhao missed the knee there. Oh, backbreaker by Main Event. Kick to the gut. Fireman's carry. Oh, Snodgrass fighting out. Oh, big belly to belly.
Now lift him up here with in suplex.
Oh!
Just spikes him down.
Look at that screwdriver. Oh, Zhao trying to get him out here. I don't know if this way of thinking is the right way for Zhao. He should have let Snodgrass finish off Main Event.
Yeah, the smart thing would be just to let two of them go at each other and then just rest up.
Exactly.
That would be the smart strategy, Cruz.
But I think these guys are so pumped up that they can't help themselves. Oh, got Zhao up in the corner. What's going to happen here?
Zhao's on the verge of being eliminated.
Snodgrass knows what to do. He's just chilling.
And there goes Zhao. We have our final two competitors, Ross Snodgrass and Main Event Jackson Ave.
Oh, my goodness. Is this it? Can Snodgrass eliminate him? Oh, he's on the apron.
Can he push him out of the ring? Can he push him to the floor? No, he can't. The final two, Renegade Ross Snodgrass, Main Event Jackson Ave, who will be the ESW YouTube champion?
Oh, they both went ahead of Steve Major. Snodgrass caught him with the clothesline first, though. Oh, stunner, taking a page out of the Hooves book. Snodgrass needs to finish him off here. And he does.
There he goes. Your winner and new ESW YouTube champion, Renegade Ross Snodgrass.
My goodness. What a match here, Steven. You know, and I want to, you know, give a shout out to every competitor here this evening. You know, everyone put forth great effort here. You know, well, only one man could win.
And that man was Renegade Ross Snodgrass.
Welcome to ESW, Ross. And there it is, the brand new ESW YouTube title. Man, that is a good-looking belt. All of our belts are pretty good-looking.
Oh, beautiful. Looks good on him, Cruz.
Oh, yeah, that red seems to work. We are very excited to see what comes next for Renegade Ross Snodgrass, the new ESW YouTube champion. Man. What an evening so far, Steven. And we just got more action yet to come.
Wrestling has only one true outcast.
Alright guys, as you see there, the impending arrival of the Outcast, Bree George, coming soon to ESW. But right now, we have the arrival of Downtown Bruno Brown.
The greatest superstar in ESW history, the greatest star in all of entertainment, I would say, Cruz.
Hard to argue with you there, Steven. Bruno Brown here, the first one out for this fatal four-way title match for the ESW Next Level title. This should be quite a showcase here. These four guys have kind of been intertwined ever since a breakout here. So it'll be interesting to see who finally gets the upper hand here.
And what's crazy about this, Cruz? This is Bruno's fifth professional wrestling match ever. And he's in a championship match. That's insane.
Are you surprised, Steven?
No, not at all, because Bruno Brown can do no wrong. He can do whatever he sets his mind to. And right now, tonight, he's setting his mind to becoming the Next Level champion. And I got my money on Bruno Brown.
And he very well could be, but I think Captain Brownbeard might have something to say about that. Brownbeard out here getting the crowd pumped here. I'm sure he's riled up on some rum already.
Oh, absolutely. I mean, they sell Captain Morgan over here, right?
Oh, I'm sure. If not, I'm sure there's an equivalent.
Yeah. I can smell it all the way over here. Just radiates off him. He doesn't even sweat. It's rum that comes out of the pores.
If anything, the rum is like is to Brown Beer like spinach is to Popeye.
Yeah, it's a PED. It's a performance enhancer.
I don't know if that should be legal then. All right, our next competitor out next, the man who lost the championship match at ESW Breakout, Varsity Ryan Evans. And he's had a bad taste in his mouth ever since.
Oh, yeah, I've talked to Varsity Ryan Evans many times. And, yeah, he's very upset that he's even in this position. He feels like he should already be Next Level champion. He cannot believe that he's lost twice now to a skeevy stoner like The Who. And that's his words, not mine, Cruz.
You always want to quote folks. Make sure everyone knows it was their words.
It's called journalism, Cruz. You have to cite your resources.
Right. Now, but I don't think Hoove's going to deny you on his recreational activity. He's not going to deny the claims.
Oh, he's very open about his extracurricular activities. And you know, I there's part of me that does sympathize with Varsity Ryan Evans. I mean, he's an athletic specimen. He just can't seem to put the right gears into play. But, I mean, The Hooge is... He's proven that he's just been untouchable.
Oh, right you are, Steven. Hooge, always wanted to celebrate our sports great history. Coming out here as The Hooge Break Kid here. Paying homage to the Heartbreak Kid, Shawn Michaels, with his attire tonight.
He's always paying homage to something.
Now, you know, maybe The Hooge can have the same result Shawn Michaels had against the British Bulldog back in 97.
Oh, absolutely.
The only difference is the crowd wouldn't hate it if the Hooge Break Kid won tonight.
Right.
Now, the Hooge is all business right now. He just came straight out.
Yeah, there's no pomp and circumstance with the Hooge. He's out here to defend his championship.
And here we go, guys. Fatal four-way action here for the Next Level championship. Here we go. Who do you have to win, Stephen?
Oh, did you even really need to ask me that?
Bruno Brown.
This is Bruno Brown's title to win, Cruz. Mark my words. There's Bruno Brown, Brown Beard, Varsity Ryan Evans, and our champion, The Who.
Here we go, guys. This should be fast. Oh.
Out of the gate, Varsity Ryan Evans with a big boot to The Who.
That was Bruno.
Oh, Bruno.
Bruno just stomped him down.
Oh, Bruno. Well, see, I'm so excited.
Oh, right you are.
Oh, big German. Oh, come on. You can't treat Bruno like that.
Oh, Brown Beard with a springboard. Brown Beard has some unusual offense for a man his size. Hooge going to the outside. Oh, Hooge getting the steps.
It doesn't surprise me that the Texan Madman is the first one to pull.
Oh, Brown Beard getting his own set there. And Brown Beard eating some steps to the spine.
And gets a senton. And meanwhile, on the inside, Bruno Brown and Varsity Ryan Evans just... Oh, what a textbook dropkick by downtown Bruno Brown.
That is one thing I can say about Bruno. He has not taken this change of career path lightly. He has taken it very seriously. You know, he has been very impressive.
He's taken to the sport like a duck to water.
I mean, I can't think of anyone that's taken to the sport as quickly, you know, other than I would say like Kurt Angle maybe.
That just shows how talented Bruno Brown is. He can do everything.
Oh, big neck breaker by Brownbeard, man.
Here we go. Former tag team partners are squaring off here.
Oh, Brownbeard with a crossface.
Taking Hoove down to the mat, trying to make him submit.
Hoove fighting out of it here. Kick to the gut. Oh, Bruno fighting out.
And a club to the back.
Bruno just taking everyone out. Oh, there's that big back Bruno suplex.
See, Bruno just on a roll.
And as you can see here, ladies and gentlemen, Lexi and Tiffany did not escort their gentleman out here this evening. I think the men let them know this was not going to be a pretty affair here tonight.
They thought better to have the women out here because this is going to be an absolute brawl.
Oh, a knockdown drag out, and it is definitely that. Hoove and Bruno in the ring. Oh, Hoove with a big super kick to the back of Bruno's head.
Hey, be careful now. That's a national treasure.
Hoove with a DDT. Oh.
Oh, I think he just busted Varsity Ryan Evans open.
With that knee to the face.
Oh, now Fireman's Carry here. And just hangs him up there on the ropes.
Brownbeard bringing a chair into the ring. Oh.
Yeah, this is not going to be pretty at all. This is going to be a definition of a car crash.
Oh, right you are, Steven. Oh, Brownbeard fighting out of that suplex.
Manages to squirm out. And now he sets him up here with an electric chair. Turns it around into a sit-out powerbomb.
What power by Brownbeard.
Into a cover.
Bruno breaks it up. And the first one to get a fall here is the winner. This is not elimination.
Now into the cover here, Varsity Ryan Evans, but doesn't even get a one count. Bruno just too good.
Oh, to the back of the head of Evans. Evans just can't get out the gate here.
I don't know what it is. Evans just has been way off his game these past few weeks.
But Bruno here definitely, you know, definitely being the highlight so far tonight.
I think the loss to Hoove, the breakout, just really like shattered him. Shattered his confidence.
That may be. Oh, another one of those back Bruno slams. My goodness. Oh, what's Bruno
now
going
setting
for
up
here?
For that Bruno Driver 94 and just spikes him into the mat.
That could be it.
He goes into the cover.
Got a two kick. Oh!
The Hoove kicked out of the Bruno Driver 94.
Bruno complained to the ref that was a slow count.
And now he's got Varsity Ryan Evans, the Rum Driver by Brownbeard.
Oh.
Now he throws Brownbeard out of the ring.
Brownbeard fighting back.
But Bruno fighting back, dropping the elbow. And now, oh, what a suplex by the Hoove.
Yeah, that Sidewinder suplex.
Now he picks up Varsity Ryan Evans.
Oh, Bruno just ate it.
A tilt-a-whirl sidewalk slam.
DDT to the injured face of Evans. In it.
Now Brownbeard's going up top.
What's he have in mind here? Oh, big leg drop.
Now the referee was out of position there.
And Bruno stopped that.
Now he's going to try to steal the big, smart strategy by Bruno Brown. Work smarter, not harder, please.
Right you are, Steven. Oh, man.
Now it looks like Hoove's trying to go for those steel stairs again. Slides him into the ring. And now he's got Bruno up for the Rum Driver. Into the cover, but the Hoove breaks up the pin.
That could have been it.
It could have. It possibly could have been. That's a nasty move.
Oh, it is. Brownbeard rolling to the outside, taking punishment here. Hoove with that chair. Oh!
Just smashes Bruno Brown with the steel chair. You better be careful. That's a national treasure, Hoove.
Oh.
Bruno manages to get out of the way and drops him with a clothesline. Let's go, Bruno.
Back and forth here. Bruno counters. Oh, Scorpion Death Drop.
And a sit-out powerbomb on the outside by Brownbeard.
Oh, that could be it. One. Oh, and Brownbeard breaking it up here. Bruno stepping back, assessing the situation, taking it to Brownbeard here. Just slaps him in the back of the head.
And in comes a kendo stick.
Oh, Brownbeard hit a code breaker on Bruno, man. Another DDT by Brownbeard.
Rolls up Brownbeard here. Can he steal it? No, just gets a one count.
It's going to take more than that to put down Captain Brownbeard.
Into the cover here.
Kick out by Bruno. Bruno rolling to the outside.
Who's got Varsity Ryan Evans up? Transitions into a neck breaker. Into the cover. But Brownbeard stopping that pin. That's what's so difficult about this fatal four.
Oh, wait a minute. Bruno's rolling up Hoof. Ref out of position. One, two, kick out.
Hoof manages to escape.
I think if the ref would have been in position, that might have been it. He just caught him off guard there.
That's what's so difficult about a match like this is that you have to worry about the referee being in the right position and your opponent's not interrupting the pins.
Oh, right you are. There's so many moving parts. Brownbeard missed that big kick there. Yeah. Fall away slam.
The old sack of shit. Shout out Scott Hall.
Oh.
The Hoof breaking up the pin there.
Oh, Hoof went for a super kick. Missed. Brownbeard. Big German. Bruno trying to gain his composure here.
Now Hoof. Oh. Hoof with a stunner.
Oh my goodness.
On Brownbeard. Into the cover.
Oh, barely broken up by Ryan Evans.
Barely, just in the nick of time.
Oh, Evans going for an ankle lock here. That could be it.
He's trapping Hoof here in this ankle lock. Will Hoof tap out? Oh, but Brownbeard.
Breaks it up here.
Brownbeard saves it. And he just hit Brownbeard with the G-A-T-A. And now he's not done. He rolls through and hits him with it again.
Oh, Bruno. Whoa.
Bruno rolls up Varsity Ryan Evans here into the cover. And Bruno Brown has done it, Cruz. The new next level champion.
Just stole it out of nowhere here.
Bruno Brown. Bruno Brown is the next level champion, Cruz.
My goodness, I'm speechless.
In his fifth professional wrestling match, Bruno Brown, downtown Bruno Brown, is your new ESW next level champion.
My
what did I say, Cruz?
You called it, Steven. You
what
called
did
it.
I say?
Bruno Brown, victorious here tonight. My goodness.
And give
my
that
goodness.
Man his
whoa, 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 Steven, what's going on here? What's this?
What?
Let the dream begin.
What is going on?
The lights are out here. We're seeing this on our monitors. Give in to the power of the music of the night. What's the meaning of all this?
I don't know. That's today's date. That's today's date.
Wait, what is this?
Oh my God! Bruno, look out behind you! It's the Phantom! The Phantom has arrived in ESW!
Oh my.
Michael Temple is here!
I am speechless.
And he has targeted downtown Bruno Brown. Why, Phantom? The Phantom is here, Cruz!
Oh my, this should be quite a development. My goodness, I can't believe what just happened, Steven.
It truly is anarchy here tonight.
Oh, right you are. And here we have our semi-main event here tonight. The Brotherhood challenging the world's strongest men for the ESW Tag Team titles here. And look at the Brotherhood here tonight. Matching gear, matching merch. They are back together. I can't wait.
Who would have thought these two who would normally be at each other's throats are now on the same page? The Brotherhood, Juan Soto, Eric Acosta, challenging for the Tag Team Championships. And, yeah, you just love to see it, Cruz.
Oh, yeah. I mean, these guys are, you know, they're great opponents, but I think they're better partners. And when these two guys are together, I'd say they're unstoppable. I mean, they've already defeated the strongest men in the world on, on this last episode of Rise.
Oh, absolutely, yeah. They have a win over the strongest men in the world, so this is going to be very interesting.
Right you are, Steven. And here they come. The world's strongest men. I know they're some of your favorites, right?
Oh, yeah, these guys are very interesting. Like, look, I don't much care for their goofy antics in the ring, but make no mistake about it, these guys are deadly in the ring. These guys are no joke.
Oh, and I know they're going to take the Brotherhood a lot more seriously after they lost on Rise.
Oh, right you are. I mean, yeah, they really, I believe that's probably why they lost. They underestimated the Brotherhood. They didn't feel like they were going to be on the same page, and it was just going to be a walk in the park. But they saw on Rise that the Brotherhood are united as one front. So, yeah, this is going to be a strong competition for the strongest men in the world, Amos and Edgar. But I think if there's any team that can stand up to the Brotherhood, it's going to be the strongest men in the world. Now, don't forget who they defeated to become ESW Tag Team Champions.
Oh, I know, Steven, the Chosen.
Those Neanderthals, those cavemen.
Well, we haven't even seen the Chosen since then, but I'm sure they'll rear their head around at some point.
I think Father Peter is busy reprogramming.
Great verbiage there. I think that's exactly what he's doing. You know, here we go, guys. This should be a great contest here. You know, I don't know who to pick. You know, I'm one, you know, I try to be impartial, and on this one, I don't know who I would pick. Two great, formidable teams here. And if anything, I think this is exactly what Juan Soto has needed to get back on track here. You know, he's got a few singles victories. He had the tag team victory with his brother against TBA and the strongest man in the world. He's on a roll here. Let's see if he can continue that momentum.
Absolutely, yeah. Look at those gorgeous tag team championships. Yeah, like you said, Juan is
a tag team match set for one fall.
And he's found his brotherhood.
As much as probably he didn't want to admit it, he needed his brother.
Introducing the challengers at a combined weight of 514 pounds, the Brotherhood.
Looking good tonight.
And their opponents at a combined weight of 512 pounds. They are the world's tag team champions.
And that's not a moniker, Steven. That's not a gimmick. These guys are literally the strongest competitors in ESW.
Oh, absolutely. I mean, Edgar himself, pound for pound, probably the strongest man in ESW.
So here we go, guys. This should be a barn burner again here for ESW Anarchy. The semi-main event, the tag team titles. Let's go.
Starting it off here with Juan and Amos.
Here we go. Oh, Amos coming out strong here. He knows he has to take it to Soto.
Yeah, there's no fun and games here tonight. That's for sure. Clubbing blow to the spine. Dropping Juan to the mat. And in comes Edgar, utilizing these frequent tags. Smart strategy by the tag team champions.
Soto fighting out of it. Oh, big clothesline. Turn them inside out. This match should be very hard hitting up.
Oh, yeah, for sure. Yeah, this is going to be an uphill battle for both teams.
Oh, both teams are going to be feeling it tomorrow. Oh, big face raise by Soto. Again, man. Regression. Regression's what he's needing.
I have all into the ropes into the corner here.
Oh, goodness.
Smashing him in the mouth.
You know, and that's one thing about Juan. I think, you know, he for so many years, he's been the benchmark here in ESW. And I think, if anything, it kind of got to him.
Yeah, I think the pressure might have been a little bit too much. And here we are with a spike pile driver on Edgar.
Cohesive teamwork here.
And now Acosta dropping an elbow.
And like you said, I think it did get to him, the pressure. And, you know, with his brother here, it's alleviated some of that pressure.
Yeah, I mean, when you call yourself the best in the world, that's high praise. That's a lot to live up to.
Oh, Acosta with a DDT on the apron.
Man.
Edgar, oh, with that roll through kick. Now he throws him back in the ring.
Oh, the Strongmen definitely don't want to count out victory here. They want to prove themselves.
Costa fighting back here into the race.
Good float around neckbreaker here. Costa taking the turn. Oh.
What a move there by Edgar.
Vintage. There we go. Oh, big right hand.
Oh, just deadlifted him with a German.
With ease.
And Acosta is not a small man.
Oh, not at all. Oh, Edgar just...
It's that old school, you know, wrestling technique.
Acosta picking up.
That catch-as, catch-can.
Right you are, Steven. Acosta fighting out here.
Shots in the midsection. Edgar continuing to lay on the attack. Oh, what a neck breaker.
Going for the cover here.
Into the cover for Juan.
Saves the day for his brother.
Juan breaking up that pin, but Amos just was not quick enough.
Oh, man, just tossed him over.
Again, that strength. Now in comes Amos, the big man.
Amos dodged that clothesline. Oh. Acosta blocked the belly to belly.
Amos there picks him back up.
Oh, big punch. Back and oh, block. Oh, head big butt. Headbutt.
Now he's got him up here in suplex position. And just drops him. Textbook.
Soto begging for the tag here.
Soto looking for that hot tag, and Eric Costa a little worse for wear here.
Oh!
Just throws him up.
Splatters him.
Splats on the mat, you're right. And, oh, what a discus punch, and I think it might have opened him up.
Into the corner.
Amos is just relentless here. Goes up top here. And just falls with an elbow drop.
My unorthodox offense here. Could be it. Oh, Costa kicks out.
Costa has too much fight left in.
Oh, big forearm smash. He needs to make a tag here.
He really does. He needs to get a fresh man in there. He is hurting.
Goodness.
Oh, lands with a big uppercut. Juan saving the match here.
All right, here we go.
And, oh, roll through there. Countered the belly to belly.
Oh, both went for a clothesline. Didn't get it. Oh, another one by Costa. He needs to make the tag.
And What's
going on here?
Juan just dropped it. Juan's deserting Eric Acosta.
Oh, man. I can't. Well, maybe I can believe it.
He just deserted his partner.
His brother.
Eric Acosta is now out here alone against the ESW Tag Team Champions.
My goodness. We're going to have to get a word with Juan sometime soon to see what's going on here.
I mean, I know he's been going through a lot, but he just turned his back on his own brother.
My goodness.
And now, I mean, the tag team champions are going to have to do what they do to retain their championships. And now Eric Acosta has to go at this alone.
Oh, you know, you know he's got to be thinking about, you know, what just happened.
That has to be weighing heavy on his mind right now, throwing him way off his game. But here he goes under the cover, but Edgar kicking out. Now, you got to give it to Acosta here. He's valiantly still fighting.
Oh, right you are. He's trying. You know, Acosta's not one to give up.
I mean, what if he beats the tag champions on his own? What does that mean?
If Soto is co-champion still? That would be quite a dynamic there.
Very interesting. Now, with that roll through, German...
My goodness.
And bridges into the pin. But Acosta getting the shoulder up. And now Edgar just showing out to the crowd.
I mean, I don't blame the strong men. You know, they have the, obviously they have the advantage here.
They have the advantage oh, what a drop kick. They have the advantage and the love of the crowd. Here we go, into the cover, but Amos saving the match. And now Eric Acosta going up top. Drops the elbow, drives it right into the heart of Edgar, into the cover. But again, a kick out.
Oh, stomp to the hands.
That's a very smart strategy. You can't use your hand. If you're, you only have one hand, that's, you know, gonna...
Yeah, you can't suplex someone.
Exactly. Edgar with those chops. Throws him into the corner. And a big monkey flip out of the corner. Now Edgar's all fired up. He's got him up on his shoulders. We've seen this before, this UFO.
My goodness.
Makes me dizzy just watching it.
Oh, I know.
Now into the corner, into the ropes.
Now into the corner.
Now into the corner, yeah. Now a punch to the face. And a tag into Amos. And yet we've seen this before. The blast from the past.
Oh, and that's, that should be it right
there.
Put
away many teams in the past.
Good effort by Eric Acosta.
One.
Oh.
Eric Acosta just kicked out of the blast from the past.
He is on a mission here tonight.
I can't believe this. He is.
Oh, he just.
And a strikeout. He could do this on his own. Into the cover. But Amos. Oh, Amos still able to kick out.
If anything, I think the strong men are still fairly fresh. Oh,
yeah,
big drop kick.
In comparison to Eric Acosta, he's just in a world of hurt here.
Oh, Amos just showing out for the crowd here.
I mean, Eric Acosta's putting up a hell of a fight, but... There's Amos. Those big right hands here. And now into the corner again. And a tag back in.
No, just back and forth.
And they're just wearing Eric Acosta down even more with the double suplex.
Into the corner.
Back into the corner. Oh. Eric Acosta continuing the fight. Valiant effort. Now a tag back into Amos. It looks like they're setting up for it again. The blast from the past for the second time into the cover.
And that's got to be it.
And three. The strongest men in the world retain the ESW Tag Team Championships. Like I said, a valiant effort by El Jefe, Eric Acosta. But after being deserted by his brother Juan Soto, he just didn't stand a chance against the best tag team in ESW.
Oh, right you are, Stephen. I mean, if anything, this night has left us with more questions than answers so far.
And that blast from the past, the winners, the strongest men in the world, Amos and Edgar, retaining their titles.
My goodness. All right, everyone, let's get ready for our main event here at ESW Anarchy.
The following contest,
Miles Martin, the first one out here for the Heavyweight Championship Triple Threat match.
The disruptor, Miles Martin, and he made his way into this main event match by basically getting attacked by REM.
Oh,
wait a second. King Anthony Martin, Miles Martin's cousin, he's just assaulting the disruptor. Why is he doing this?
This is truly anarchy here tonight.
And, oh, what a suplex on that ramp. He's assaulting his cousin.
My goodness.
In front of his hometown crowd. And the fans, they're in disbelief here, just like we all are.
My goodness. I know we had touched on these two not necessarily being the best of friends, but I think King Martin here is, he may be perturbed that he's not in the main event and Miles is.
I mean, King Anthony Martin has been on a roll since making his return here to ESW, but, I mean, earning a championship match, this isn't how you do it, King.
My goodness.
He's just assaulting the Disruptor here. I mean, the Disruptor still has his Guy Fawkes mask on.
Oh, my goodness. How's this going to play out?
Yeah, right before the main event here, the biggest match of Miles Martin's career.
My goodness. Oh!
Just turns him inside out there with a lariat.
Just stomping him. We need to get some...
We need security out here.
Miles trying to fight out of it.
Trying to fight back here, put up a fight here. And he does so.
This is definitely not what Miles needs here right now.
Right you are. I mean, his mind was on R.E.M. and Shigeru Kimura, not his cousin.
Oh, my goodness.
Anthony Martin.
Oh!
Those Kawada kicks.
We need to get security out here right now, guys. What is going on here tonight, Steven?
I have no idea. I mean, it truly is anarchy here tonight. On tonight's show. I mean,
my goodness.
This is awful.
Oh. Well, it looks like Miles finally made it to the ring. They got Anthony Martin out of here, and Miles is going to try and compose himself as we get ready for the main event here.
Here comes one of the participants here in the triple threat main event for the ESW World Heavyweight Championship. Here comes the Kaiju Killer, Shigeru Kimura, and he's looking for redemption. He feels like he was embarrassed at Breakout by losing in such fashion to R.E.M.
R.E.M. was steamrolling everyone, and Shigeru was no exception.
And then he got his rematch on Fight Night a few weeks ago, and R.E.M. just assaulted him with a kendo stick yet again for the second time, causing a disqualification.
So you're right, Kimura is out for blood and the ESW Heavyweight Championship here tonight.
He is all business here.
As we anticipate the arrival of our World Heavyweight Champion.
Ronald Eugene McCulley, the man who has steamrolled all of his opponents to becoming the ESW World Heavyweight Championship. He is going to make wrestling great again. And look at him, Uncle Sam. Coming out decked in the stars and stripes, and this crowd absolutely hates it.
My goodness. And I don't think it's so much that the UK crowd here hates the USA as much as they just hate R.E.M.
Oh, absolutely. It's like he just threw their tea in the harbor.
Look at him telling the fans off.
He's telling them exactly what he thinks about them. He doesn't really care much for the UK, and I don't think the UK care much for him.
And that doesn't matter to R.E.M.
No, the only thing that there's only two things that matter to R.E.M. That's checks, championships, and the good old U.S. of A.
That's three things, Steven.
Well, the U.S. of A just means a whole lot to him. It's not a thing to R.E.M.
It's a lifestyle.
It's exactly.
All right, here we go, guys. Let's get ready for our main event. Triple Threat World Heavyweight Championship here. Who do you have your money on, Steven?
Well, I mean, going into this match, you would think the hometown man would have the advantage, but after that assault by his cousin, King Anthony Martin, I gotta say, I'm gonna still stick with R.E.M.
I think Miles Martin can pull out the victory here.
Even, you think so?
That's who I want to win. I want Miles to win. I want that good go-home moment.
Well, we shall see what's gonna happen here in the main event of ESW Anarchy. Now Shigeru Kimura going right after R.E.M., but R.E.M. fighting out. Clubbing blow. Now R.E.M. just stomping away here. And R.E.M. again just proving just why he's so dominant. Picks up Kimura here and just slams him with a powerbomb. Now he just clips Miles Martin.
Here we go, guys.
Now Miles Martin is trying to fight out. But Shigeru Kimura has that kendo stick, but REM takes it away and, ooh, right to the midsection. Sends REM into the corner. And what an overhead belly-to-belly suplex. And now it looks like that attack hasn't had much of an effect on Miles Martin. He is on a roll here.
You know, I'm still interested to hear what King Anthony Martin is going to have to say about this.
Yeah, I want to see what his justification is for that assault earlier. And now REM continuing with the assault with the kendo stick.
Oh, REM, him and that kendo stick have become best friends as of late.
He's hitting everyone in the dome.
Breaking it over Kimura here.
Just splintering it apart. Now REM just with a big right hand.
Kimura, back suplex hanging on into a German.
Now keeps the waist locked. Counters into a brain buster.
My goodness. Non-stop action here.
That's what it's been all night long.
It truly has been anarchy. Like I said, we have a lot of questions coming out of this event here
tonight. A lot of questions, not a lot of answers.
Well, I know the debut of the Phantom, Soto abandoning his brother, King Anthony Martin's unprovoked attack. It's been chaos.
Right you are. Now look at this. Oh, what an interesting suplex there.
Right on the arm. And you know what Kimura's doing there.
Oh, yeah, wearing down that arm for the Kimura lock. Well, what a slam. Almost dropped him on the top of his head.
REM coming back with some offense. REM, you know, don't take REM's attire lightly. That, you know, he's all business, you know.
Oh, there's a reason why he's so dominant. He's been steamrolling everyone. A kick out there on one count. He's a big dude, and he's nasty, and he's mean, and that's why he's ESW World Heavyweight Champion.
Oh, he pulls no punches. No, he throws potatoes in the ring. Verbally and physically.
Oh, yeah, he's serving up hash browns 24-7. Now, side rushing leg sweep. REM sends him into the corner. And we've seen this before, this big forearm smash. And he's setting up for it. Going for the GOB, but Miles Martin slips out.
Kimura bringing the chair in.
What's he going to do with that chair?
Missed the chair shot. Oh.
REM clipped him. Now he's going for another weapon here, going back to the drawing board. Now he's got that GOS, the good old sleeper. Locked in on Miles Martin. But Kimura breaks it up.
Missed that heel kick.
And now he's going to take advantage here, but REM breaks up the pin.
He says, nah, nah.
Not today. Now REM picks up Miles Martin once again. He's got him up. And hits him with the Alabama Slam.
REM on a roll here. Oh, REM with a chair this time. Oh, wearing him out.
He slams him across Miles Martin. Went for it on Kimura, but he paid for it.
Oh, took his head off there.
What a big lariat. By REM.
Reminiscent of JBL and Stan Hansen there. Oh, REM with a big right hand just knocked Kimura down.
It looks like he's got Miles Martin up. Hits him with the GOB on the outside. And those mats are paper thin. And now he's got Kimura up going for the GOB on him. But Kimura, he had it scouted.
Oh, counter dropped on that arm.
Wearing him down for the Kimura lock. And went low. And that's as legal as a headlock.
Uncharacteristic for Shigeru here.
I think he's looking to win by any means necessary. Oh, what a swinging slam there. Kicks out at two. Miles Martin's got REM. Throws him into the corner.
Oh.
REM fighting out. Now shoulder block takes Kimura down.
Fighting out.
Fighting out from a go behind. And now he's got him in with the GOS. The good old sleeper. He's got it locked in. Is Miles going to have to tap? And Miles taps.
Kimura, too late there.
REM retains his championship in this main event match.
My goodness, what a match here.
Let's take another look here. That big forearm. And that GOB on the outside, the good old bomb. And here comes the GOS, the good old sleeper. That was all she wrote for Miles Martin. And Kimura was just 1 millisecond too late.
That was it. What an evening we've had here tonight, folks. ESW Anarchy, REM retaining the ESW World Heavyweight Championship here. Quite a contest. Like I said, we have a lot of answers that we need, and a lot of questions came up here this evening. But congratulations to REM retaining the ESW World Heavyweight Championship. And what a night, Stephen. What a night.
What a show, Cruz. Anarchy is an understatement.
All right, guys. Thank you so much for joining us here tonight. And we will actually be taking a little bit of a break. We'll be coming back to you with an episode of Rise. When was that date, Stephen? November what?
It's the November 21st.
And then we'll be back with Fight Night that Saturday. Thank you, guys. Good night.